respected Professor Senapati ji, Honorable Director of NCIIT, respected Mr. Eric Holt, Director and Representative of UNESCO, respected Professor Sui Hin Tho, respected Dr. Huma Masood, dear Major Harsh Kumar, Professor Mandal, all the country representatives from Bangladesh, Bhutan, Nepal, Maldives, Sri Lanka, and from my own country, India, and my colleagues from NCIIT, officials from UNESCO, and other collaborating institutions of this sub-regional meeting. First of all, I am very happy to be here this morning, and I sincerely thank the Honorable Director NCIIT for providing this opportunity to be with you. Education is a powerful tool to build a knowledge-based society. The constant endeavor, therefore, should always be to improve and expand education in all sectors with a view to eliminate disparities in access and lay greater emphasis on the improvement in the quality, in the relevance, and in the excellence of education, including teacher training. The belief that good teaching will improve learner achievement forms the basis for prioritizing teacher development and investing heavily on teacher training programs. I am reminded of the Radhakrishnan Commission long back, which made recommendations in 1948, and it strongly believed in the central role of teachers in shaping minds of students and emphasized the need for teachers to arouse curiosity and evoke the spirit of critical inquiry among the students. The Commission emphasized the importance of the teacher being regularly updated with the latest developments in the field. Dr. Radhakrishnan, who was a great teacher, our former President of India, and coincidentally, who was also the Vice Chancellor of Banaras Hindu University, where I had also the privilege of working as Vice Chancellor. He used to say that the best minds should come to teaching. Friends, the quality of teachers is an important factor influencing learning outcomes, skills, social behavior, and moral values of the students. The teachers can play an important role in shaping lifestyles and developing concerns for human rights, gender equality, promotion of culture of peace and nonviolence by the students. I look at teachers as the role models. I look at the teachers as the torch bearers of the society, for the society. I look at the teachers as the touchstones who impacts the life and conduct of the students in various ways, in the classrooms, in the campuses, and also outside the classrooms. Therefore, in our system, emphasis should be there to train the teachers on continual basis so that they keep themselves abreast of the latest developments in their domain areas and use of ICT in achieving the objective of imparting the quality and relevant knowledge to the students. Here, I would like to make a mention of UGC's new initiatives, where UGC for the first time has taken decision that all newly appointed teachers, there would be an induction program of 1 month. It would not be subject specific, but it would be generic, where the students, the teachers, their role as the role models on the campuses and for the society, and their role in inculcation of human values and professional ethics, their role in promoting environment and sustainability, in promoting gender sensitization, in promoting ICT-enabled education, in promoting social cohesion, and also in promoting national integration will be emphasized. We are also going to start in a big, big from this academic session, and that is again happening for the first time, that we will be organizing 1 week induction program for all the new entrants who will be joining the universities and colleges, where students will be acquainted with the culture of that particular institution, the locality, the expectations which are there from them as the students, and also their issues will also be addressed. Besides this, on continuous basis, we are also making refresher training for all the teachers in higher education, which is about 14 lakhs now, annually through online SWAYAM, about the various developments which will be taking place in their area of domain. Friends, the quality assurance mechanisms and qualification frameworks help institutions to fix learning targets and monitor teaching and learning processes. Traditionally, teaching and learning processes revolved around the course contents, textbooks, teachers, and lectures. In the present context, with the advancement of technology, teaching and learning process has transformed from a classroom-based institutional level activity to a globally connected interactive process. I feel that good and effective teachers should have deep content knowledge, good pedagogical skills and capacity to manage classroom situations. A teacher should know what to teach, how to teach, and how to improve student learning. Teaching is not only about subject knowledge and methods of delivery in the classroom, but also about developing the teaching processes so that learning of a diverse group of learners is promoted. The teacher should be trained to design, develop, transact, and assess the learning outcome-based curriculum, and such curriculum should be, I feel, relevant and responsive to the learner characteristics and learning needs of the students. It should be effective in terms of meeting the stated educational objectives. This curriculum should be equitable and inclusive, capable of ensuring that all students attain the expected learning outcomes at program and course level. The teachers should ensure a learning process which facilitates the students attain the attributes such as disciplinary knowledge, communication skills, critical thinking, problem solving, analytical reasoning, research literary skills, collaboration, cooperation, teamwork, scientific reasoning, using quantitative, qualitative data, reflective thinking, information and digital literacy, moral and ethical awareness, reasoning, multicultural competence, self-directed learning, lifelong learning, leadership qualities, and also community engagement. Most importantly, the teachers should impart value-based education to the students and create a strong learning environment that enhances academic attainment and develops students' social skills, soft skills that last throughout their life. The focus should primarily be on holistic development and on universal values such as truth, righteous conduct, peace, non-violence, and love. The expectations from the educational institutions and the teachers are to create a culture and environment which facilitate awareness and delivery of value-based education for producing graduates which are globally competent and locally relevant. Government of India have taken several initiatives with regard to teachers training, which includes, I mentioned about induction program, setting of teachers learning centers and faculty development centers, online training through MOOCs on SWAYAM portal, human resource developments under the UGC, and also national resource centers within the MHRD. for holistic development of students, programs like credit course for summer internship in villages, environmental studies as a mandatory course, Swachhata ranking of institutions, Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat Abhiyan, celebration of International Yoga Day, and many other days of national importance are in this direction. मुझे प्रसन्नता है कि डॉक्टर हुमा मसूद ने बहुत अच्छे ही श्लोक के साथ और भारतीय संस्कृति के बारे में बताते हुए कार्यक्रम की शुरुआत की. हमारे यूनेस्को के डायरेक्टर साहब ने भी शुरुआत में कुछ हिंदी के शब्दों को प्रयोग किया. मुझे लगता है कि मैं बात अपनी बात जो पूरी करूं वो हिंदी में करूं, और मुझे लगता है कि काफ़ी लोग यहाँ समझ भी लेंगे इसको. ये देश जाना जाता है एक सभी को साथ लेकर चलने के लिए, सहकार के लिए, शांति के लिए, परस्पर सद्भाव के लिए, सौहार्द के लिए, भाईचारे के लिए और सामपोष्य विकास या सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट के लिए जो भी आवश्यक हैं उसकी संस्कृति विकसित करने के लिए. हमारे भारतीय विचारकों ने, हमारे पुरोधाओं ने, हमारे फिलोसोफर्स ने, हमारे एजुकेटर्स ने वो ज्ञान, वो तत्व ज्ञान पूरे विश्व को दिया है जिसके माध्यम से हम दया, करुणा, शांति, सद्भावना, प्रेम जैसे जो मूल्य हैं उन पर चल कर के आगे बढ़ सकते हैं, सबको साथ लेकर के सबको खुशहाल जीवन देने की राह बता सकते हैं. मुझे लगता है कि जो ग्लोबल सिटीजनशिप एजुकेशन है उसी के लिए महत्वपूर्ण है. लर्निंग टू लिव टुगेदर, एक दूसरे के जो भाव हैं हम उसका सम्मान करें, एक दूसरे के जो व्यूज़ हैं उसको हम रेस्पेक्ट करें, एक दूसरे के जो ट्रेडिशंस हैं, एक दूसरे के जो लैंग्वेजेस हैं, एक दूसरे के जो कल्चर हैं, एक दूसरे के जो रिलीजियस फेथ हैं उन सब का हम सम्मान करें, और ऐसी शिक्षा हमको सबको साथ लेकर के चलने की एक राह दिखाती है. मुझे लगता है कि हम सब मिलकर के ये करने की कोशिश करें और एक भविष्य में एक खुशहाल शांत प्रिय विश्व देखने की जिज्ञासा रखें. धन्यवाद. जय हिंद.